Mizoram's assembly elections are here. And why should you care? Because Mizoram does matter. In the way of Prime Minister Narendra Modi's dream of a Congress-mukt Bharat, the tiny state of Mizoram stands tall. It is still a Congress-ruled state with Chief Minister and Mizo strongman Lal Thanawla in charge. But winning Mizoram might be a bit tricky for the BJP. Here's why. So Mizoram became a full-fledged state in February 1987. The Mizo National Front, or the MNF, was the regional party that fought for a separate Mizo statehood. More than the BJP, it is this party that's been the Congress's main opponent since then. In Mizoram's first elections, which were held in 1987, the MNF won 24 seats and its leader, Lal Degna, became the first chief minister. The Congress, under Lal Thanawla, won only 13 seats. The vote share difference between the MNF, which was at 43.3%, and the Congress, which was at 32.9%, was only 10.3%. So between 1987 and 2008, for 21 years, the MNF remained in power. But by 2003, we saw the Congress finally catching up with the MNF, which at that point of time was part of the BJP-led NDA alliance. So in 2003, the Congress bagged 12 seats and the MNF bagged 21. But the vote share difference had fallen to just 1.6%. So in 2008, the Congress finally won the Mizoram elections, bagging 32 seats and a vote share of 38.9%, way ahead of the MNF, which was left with only 3 seats and a vote share of 30.6%. A big gap of over 8% between the MNF and the Congress, with the Congress now ahead. The BJP, incidentally, got just 0.5% of the vote share in 2008. In 2013, the vote share difference rose to almost 16%, with an increasingly popular Congress bagging 34 seats and a vote share of 44.6%. Lal Thanawla became the chief minister again. A sidelined MNF won just 5 seats with a vote share of 28.6%. The BJP again scored 0.4% of the vote share. So let's meet the kings who are also the kingmakers. So now we're in 2018 and Congress's Lal Thanawla and MNF's Zoram Thanga, who have both been chief ministers before, are ready to do battle again. 76-year-old Lal Thanawla aims to be chief minister for the record 5th term. And 84-year-old Zoram Thanga, who inherited Lal Degna's MNF legacy, needs a win for his political survival. Citing anti-incumbency and corruption charges, Zoram Thanga has claimed that the Congress won't win even 10 seats this time around. Meanwhile, Lal Thanawla is equally confident of winning yet again. The BJP too, not to be forgotten, has been trying to gain momentum. Their main election agenda is the repatriation of the Bru refugees who fled the state in 1997 following several ethnic clashes. So why does the BJP want the Brus back so badly? The BJP's main motive in bringing the Brus back from Tripura is that since most of them are Hindu, they would provide a strong voter base for the BJP in a predominantly Christian state. Luckily for them, the Brus too want to come back and become a part of the Mizo electorate. Another hope for the BJP is a possible tie-up with the MNF, like in 2003. And if that happens, the BJP actually has more chances of winning seats in the polls. But with the MNF dismissing these tie-up rumours, the battle for Mizoram is actually wide open. To find out who won, join us on The Quint on 11 December, the counting day.